Hey everybody, just so thankful again to be able to come into your home. We're excited about what God is doing in the life of His people. Listen, we talked about the book of Ephesians last week, Ephesians chapter 6, dealing with warfare, outfitting to battle, being able to have the right wardrobe on, being able to have the right garments on, the right uniform for battle. The Bible talks about praying and watching, but what's the use of watching if you have no idea what to look for? You have to understand that the enemy, Satan, Lucifer, is our chief enemy. He's a deceiver. He's a trickster. He's a dangerous liar. So the Bible says, be strong in the Lord. Finally, my brethren, and in the power of His might, you have to put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to deal with the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers of this world, against rulers of the darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, you have to be able to stand. But after you're strong in the Lord and in the power of this might, you'll be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, the wiles, the method, the schemes, the craftiness of the enemy. That word wiles comes from the Greek word methodia, from which we get our word method, his method of operation. And you may not be able to keep Satan from knocking you or putting you down, but you can mind the way you respond to what he does to you. That's why you need faith in God. You need to believe God when things are snatched away, pulled away from you. You got to believe God sometimes allow things to get away from you to increase you, to give you more than enough. So I believe God in this particular hour is resting in his own power and his sovereignty to let you know that things are going to be all right. And I'm a witness that God will bring you through. He will take you over. You will be able to cross on the other side, but you got to hang on in there. He is working behind the scenes, being able to take you where he always wanted to place you. So remember now, don't give up, don't quit, don't cave in, don't collapse, don't throw in the towel because of ignorance and fear. You got to die in that fear, you got to make sure you put it under your feet and you walk in the power of God, because God will see you through.